Jazz. Kyrie Irving is out there with J.R. Smith. And they've got LaMarcus Aldridge, the former number two pick out of Texas, standing tall in the middle at 6'11". Then it's Pierce, and it's Carter in at the foreshot. And looking at the Nuggets, Chris Paul is out there with Harden. And holding down the middle, tremendously hard-working and versatile big man out of the Dominican Republic, Al Horford. Then it's Paul George, and it's Anthony in a power forward. Because they're the second seed, they'll have home court advantage through the next two rounds.
Slick play right there. He's so resourceful with the ball in his hands.
Calling in Irving. Puts up a three. And it's going to be out of bounds. The Jazz will take it. Now we're going to get a chance to check in with Doris Burke. We had a talk moments ago with head coach Ty Corbett. Doris?
You can put coach in the crowd that feels game one is the most important game in the series. He said to take the first game on the road would put us in the driver's seat for a mental advantage as well as a home court advantage. Guys?
Thank you, Doris.
You know, as much as anybody in the league, Pierce is able to hit the tough contest.
Oh, what a play!
Oh, look at that.
That is a
bringing down the house.
There's no stopping him when he gets to the basket like that. If you can't foul him in time, just get out of the way.
That was a great angle we just saw, courtesy of Sprite.
Kevin, I didn't like that defensive effort at all, but they're lucky he missed it.
Yeah, they were very lucky defensively because there was some miscommunication there. They left him wide open.
A rim rucker.
Looked for a second like he might rip the cylinder loose.
Now that is some strength there, guys.
Now here is Smith, averaging 19 points per contest. Nailed from three-point land. Smith's got 6 points.
And the offense, I mean, 3 of 4, a solid start for this game.
When the big fella goes up like that, you better get out of the way.
The Nuggets shooting their first free throw of the game right now. Jazz have gone 3 of 4 from the field to start out the game. Carter outside. They grab their own miss.
He actually did a nice job there reading how that shot was going to come off the rim perfectly. I mean, that can make up for any height disadvantage.
Now here's Anthony, averaging 10 points per contest. Here's Harden. Good, and Paul gets the assist. Harden's got his first points of the night.
Soft defense right there. Way too soft.
Here's Dix to Carter. Here in the first, just under 2.5 minutes played so far. And there's the rejection. Unloads. That's good for George on the assist by Paul. And that's now 7 points here for George. Jazz trailed by 4. Carter outside. Knocks down the 3-ball.
Boy, that's too easy. You cannot let a shooter that good get a warm-up jump shot like that. If you do that, it'll be raining all day from out there.
Now here's Paul, averaging 20 points per game. Back to George. It's taken away by Smith. Irving for 3, and Anthony sends it back. And there's the call on Kyrie Irving. That is his first foul of the game. Harden with it, averaging 12 points a game. Paul, the feed to George. Some nice ball movement by the Nuggets. Horford, and that one's good. Horford's got his third basket of the night right there. Jazz trailed by 3. Smith with it, and it's Harden picking him up from deep. Cannot hit, and the Nuggets going the other way. It's game number 2 of the season versus the
Jazz. Oh, get it! Oh, what now?
Guys, I'm going to need just a second to get myself together here.
Leaves you speechless, doesn't it, Clark? Huh?
Wow. Man, I don't blame you, Clark. That dunk was unbelievable.
Irving for 3. Again, Irving missing. The Nuggets leading by 5. They've definitely hit that groove offensively.
They sure have, guys. I mean, really aggressive. And I like that posture and mindset. Stay aggressive.
Yeah. Steve, you like groove, don't you?
I do. I love groove, Kevin. And I love the attack mode this team is in, too. I mean, they're really getting into the paint. They're getting whatever they want offensively.
Wow, here is Horford. 8 points for him. And the shot is good.
Beautiful there. They're trying to pull away.
Well, with smart basketball, little by little, they're building on their lead here.
Timeout is called, first of the game for the Jazz.
Yeah, he's seen enough of this interior scoring that his defense is giving up. So the message during his timeout is to lock things up inside.
You know, sometimes a group can just get spaced out on defense. They're not connected and playing five as one. And usually a timeout can help you refocus and recalibrate that defense.
So Utah ends up going with the new group. Harden with it. Ball outside. And the pass to George. He kicks to Carmelo. Again, the Nuggets score.
They're clicking offensively. A nice rhythm here, coming out strong.
Shooting an excellent percentage. That's why they've got the lead.
Redick for three, and the Jazz another three.
That's nine straight points coming off three three-pointers. The defense just getting shelled.
Steve, the threes are killing them. I think they've got to find...
Oh, man, what a play. Don't do that to him. That was fantastic. Wow.
And Clark, the degree of difficulty.
Major. That was amazing.
And here's Felton from the arc. And that one's good.
And if their last five makes, all have been from long range.
Yeah, and the defense has not done a good job of pressing in and denying. I mean, they're hanging back, playing on their heels. They're not being the aggressors here, and the offense is taking advantage of it.
Anthony with the bucket.
Great action. Back-to-back three-pointers at either end.
Sort of an anything you can do, I can do better situation going on right here, guys.
Beyond the arc. And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Steve Nash. That is his first foul of the game.
Obviously, he's not afraid of physical play, but he still needs to play in control.
And he definitely wasn't in control that time. Everybody in the building knew it was an over-the-back call.
And that one's good, Anthony.
Even when they're D'ing him up, I mean, he's a very good shooter from out there.
Jazz trailed by eight. Nash outside. And they come right back with their own three-pointer. Nash has got his second bucket of the night. Timeout is called, first of the game for the Nuggets.
Well, he looks like he wants to toy around with some of their sets and matchups here.
You know, I don't think you can afford to go through a whole game doing the same thing over and over, and you have to be able to adjust on the fly, just like he's doing here.
The Nuggets shooting their second and third free throws tonight. Good on both.
Another trip to the line, and he's right on the mark. He's not a guy you want to get in the habit of putting on the stripe.
Jazz have gone 8 of 15 from the field, shooting above 50% here tonight. And here's Felton from the arc. The rebound by Paul George. The Nuggets leading by 7. Harden dishes to Melo, and he uses both hands to jam it in.
Threw it down with authority.
Oh, he can really fly. And you combine that, Clark, with some of the nice penetration, too. And you've got an easy 2 points.
Yeah, that's good stuff there. And he's able to play well above the rim, but the execution really got him that look.
Harden the pass to Paul. George jacks up a three. And their work on the board pays off with the second chance points. And the Nuggets lead by 11.
This game is really going their way early. What a lead they've built up.
And that's thanks to their performance offensively. In large measure, I mean, they're actually scoring with ease here.
And the foul called on Paul Millsap. That's his first foul of the game, and the bonus will go to the free throw line. The Nuggets shooting their fourth and fifth shots at the foul line in the game. Both free throws good from Anthony. Jazz trailed by 13. Here's Redick. Right now averaging 5 points a game.
And I think the work on the boards has been a big key for their success in this game, guys.
Yeah, I couldn't agree with you more. I mean, it's been total control on the boards for them.
And another miss by Denver.
Well, as far as jump shots go, that's as high percentage as it gets.
I'm not sure how that didn't go down.
George against Felton. They can't stop the run with that one.
Yeah, he's struggled with his shot this quarter, and he's got to find a groove somehow.
The shot by George, no good. The Jazz shooting just about an even 40% to start. Redick for three, gets it to go. Redick's got 6 points.
Well, he did a nice job of getting himself into just enough of an open area to find that spot for his shot. They built an early lead here, really pushing ahead.
Well, they got a huge advantage points in the paint, Steve, and they're attacking early, so taking advantage of scoring in close.
Felton against Harden. Lets it go with a three. And the Jazz, another three.
That's 12 straight points coming off three-pointers. I mean, somebody do something defensively.
Well, I agree with you. I mean, who's going to step up? They're rolling out there now, so you got to get in their chest, make them uncomfortable, and try to deny those looks.
The Nuggets leading by seven. Paul with the ball, guarded now by Nash. Paul kicks to Anthony. Takes a three. A rebound by the Jazz. Nash outside. From the arc. And it's Denver with the rebound. George has got his fourth rebound. And
what a huge play.
I tell you what, you need to archive that book for the highlight tape.
Oh, yeah, that is a keeper. You're correct.
Man, that was incredible.
Yeah, man, those plays will give your team a huge boost.
And the Jazz call time here. You have to like what we're seeing from Carmelo Anthony.
He's really taking it to him inside. They got to find a way to slow him down.
And the Nuggets with some changes. Garnett comes in for George. And it's Kemba Walker in for Chris Paul. Utah also making some changes. Paul Pierce has checked in for Lopez. Aldridge comes in for Paul Millsap. And Mo Williams subbed in for Steve Nash. Denver in the lead. Harden dishes to Horford. And he throws it down with one hand.
Not stopping. There's no way to stop that. I mean, there's nothing you can do when he's coming at him like that.
Well, that's right, Clark. Steve, he is a dangerous, dangerous player.
Yeah, especially when he gets to that launching pad right there in the lane. I mean, pretty one-handed finish. That was not.
Oh! How about that basketball, man? Beautiful. Wow.
They're all on the same page, no question.
And that chemistry has helped them jump out to this big first quarter lead. A cohesive team can beat a talented one almost every time.
And that is good.
That's four of their last five coming from long range. This offense is cooking.
Yeah, it's rolling, really rolling. And defensively, they kept collapsing, Steve, and leaving them open. So now they're in trouble. They're in a real dilemma now.
Horford with the block. But they recover it. Here's Pierce. Good on the leaner. And now it's only a five-point Nugget lead.
A nice piece of work there. Find a little space and pull the trigger.
Garnett. Oh!
Now we're cooking with gas, partner. My goodness.
A breathtaking display of aerial supremacy, no doubt.
It's almost unfair, guys. I mean, you can get up that high, that's crazy.
Well, they've come out of the gates with purpose and focus, just gobbling up each and every rebound.
Matt Clark, they have really asserted themselves on the glass. We'll see if they can keep this going in the second quarter.
Harden's shot is good.
Yeah, Harden is really an instant offense type guy, Kevin. He's been a role player off the bench the last couple of years, but it seems like he's ready to emerge into a star. He's instant offense when he comes into the game.
And, Steve, it's not just because Harden can get hot in a hurry. It's also because he can find ways to get the shots he wants. And he isn't just a catch-and-shoot guy. He knows when to put it on the floor, create some space, and then pull up for the two. He's also a better passer than advertised.
And Walker kicks to Harden. Rises up and throws it down.
Nicely done. They've really attacked effectively in transition.
There's no doubt about it, Steve. Their quickness has given them an advantage. I mean, I've liked the way they've pushed the ball all game.
Pierce for three. There's the bucket. Good. Pierce has got 11 points.
You got to love what he's doing out there, guys. With his team down, he's personally trying to bring them back.
Walker the pass to Garnett. In for the dunk.
It wasn't bad defense, but he got overpowered. There's not enough strength to stop him.
You know, sometimes you just try to avoid the foul, Clark, and not get in the way.
Wrong place, wrong time.
Exactly.
Yeah, no question. You guys are right. I mean, he seemed to think better of it and then backed off a little bit at the end.
Catching up on the changes for Denver. Green is checked in for Horford. Paul George comes in for Carmelo Anthony. Kyle Korver is checked in for James Harden. And it's Paul in for Kemba Walker.
Defensively, this team is just giving up way too many open looks.
You're exactly right. And to battle back, they've got to shore that defense up, Steve.
Paul dishes to George. Green. The three. And Kyle Korver hits from deep. Porter's got 5 points so far. The first. Porter concludes in a double-digit lead on the scoreboard. And we welcome you back to our presentation of Game 1. And a very convincing performance from the Nuggets so far.
Solid first quarter for this club. They came out strong and they put together some nice momentum here.
Steve, I like the looks they've gotten on offense. A lot of good ones. Well, they say control the glass, control the game. They're definitely controlling the glass.
Yeah, I agree with that. That's been the case here tonight. Big lead they're enjoying on the glass. Getting out in transition, guys. They're coming fast and furious.
They've got the D gasping for breath here with 7 straight fast break points now, Steve.
Well, after knocking down 3 three-pointers last quarter, he's starting to lose the range a little bit.
Here's Green. Good, and Ball gets the assist. Green's got himself going there. His first points of the game on the deep ball. Outside Irving. Connects from 3-point range.
Oh, they're getting scorched by all these open threes they're giving up.
Yeah, it's really been the biggest pitfall for this club so far tonight. So many wide open looks for the opponent.
Beal can't get it to go.
You know, even though he missed that 3-point shot, I think the defense has to do a better job of challenging the shot.
Yeah, because you know if you continue to give up open looks like that, you're in big trouble.
Smith for 3. It's hauled in by the Nuggets. George has got 5 rebounds tonight, and it's blocked. And that'll be Denver as it goes out of bounds. Nuggets retain possession. Denver with a platoon swap here on the floor. And Utah with a change here, too. Brook Lopez is checked in for LaMarcus Aldridge. Off the inbound. Here's Walker, and that one's good. Walker's got his first 2 points of the night.
That's an old-fashioned finish there, guys. Going to the finger roll to get the easy 2.
For 3, Smith gets the bucket.
He's picking up right where he left off in the first quarter.
The Nuggets leading by 14. To the inside. It's taken away by Smith. For the 3, gets it to go. Smith's got 12.
He's going to force the defense to make some adjustments. That's his 4th 3-pointer of the half.
Shot's good by Middleton. Jazz trailed by 13. For 3, Smith. And the Jazz, another 3.
He had a great start from the arc, and he's kicked it up even another notch here in the second.
Outside, Walker passes it to Horford. Good ball movement here by the Nuggets. The tray, good. Walker's got 5 points in the quarter.
Well, with a dead-eye shooter like him, it takes more than average defense to put a stop to it. It takes great defense, and even that might not be enough.
Utah calls timeout. After what we're seeing from Carmelo Anthony.
He's on fire. They needed to put their heads together to figure out how to get the ball out of his hand.
Kevin Garnett is checked in for Denver. Lillard comes in for Kemba Walker. Utah also making some changes. LaMarcus Aldridge is checked in for Millsap. Carter comes in for Paul Pierce. And it's Nash in for Kyrie Irving. Smith kicks to Carter. This one for 3. The shot misses. Now the Nuggets take it the other way. Here's Harden.
Oh, man, that was unreal. Mark it up.
The defense was pretty good right there, but just not good enough.
He was determined to get to the rim.
Yeah, he really was. And he was going to go through whatever and whomever got in front of him.
And the highlight reel replay. Brought to you by Sprite. Good stuff.
That's now 6 straight points off open threes. Get a hand up, fellas. Pay attention to the scouting report.
Well, you know how quickly things can go south when you start giving up wide open looks to this team.
For the Nuggets, Paul George, he's checked in for Horford. Korver comes in for James Harden. And it's Paul in for Lillard. Here's Anthony. And a great assist by Paul as that one goes in. Paul's got assist number 9 now. Wow, what an effort here tonight. Carter outside. second shot opportunity. So the whistle blows on the shot and two free throws for the contact right there.
It's been a good one for Smith.
He has 15 points, and he's buried a ton of three-pointers in this game, too.
Yeah, it's getting hard to keep track of just how many of those he's hit.
Green is checked in for Denver. The Nuggets leading by 12. Dishes it to Korver. Garnett over Smith. And he drops it in following the offensive rebound. Jazz have gone 5 of 11 from the field since the beginning of the second quarter. There's Nash with the three. Tries again. And the layup good by Smith. Smith's got 13 points in just this quarter.
My goodness, it seems like he's got every point this quarter. Just an amazing job helping to cut into this lead.
He dishes it to Garnett. Deflects the pass. Smith outside. Fires the three. Green with the rebound. Green's got three rebounds now in this one. Kicks it to George. Throws it up high.
Well, that certainly sent a ripple through the crowd.
Yeah, no, alley-oop always does that. One of the most beautiful plays you'll see in all of basketball. Yeah. It's impossible not to be impressed.
Yeah, very exciting play to see that.
Especially when it ends with that big slam like that one.
And the basket good. And it's now 22 points for J.R. Smith. Paul kicks to Green. Lets the three fly. Good, and Paul gets the assist.
That's his second shot from long range in this quarter, so he's starting to roll.
Smith outside. They double him with George. Nash kicks to Carter. Six on the shot clock. And again, it's the Jazz from deep. The Nuggets leading by 11. And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Steve Nash. And that'll be his third foul so far. Paul Pierce has checked in for the Jazz. Kyrie Irving comes in for Steve Nash. And there's Paul George on the assist by Paul. And that's 13 points here for George. Irving passes to Carter. Three-pointer, and the Jazz another three.
Well, the defense not doing a good job at all of getting after him. They've got to crowd him and make it tough for him. That's his second this quarter.
Paul kicks to George. In low to Garnett. Over Carter, and Denver again with the bucket.
Smart, he's just using his size advantage to get his shot off.
And a sweet stroke, too, you might add.
Smith dishes to Aldridge. Right side, Aldridge. Pierce for three, and that one's good. Pierce has got 14 points.
Now let's see if that triggers another explosion from, remember, he hit three three-pointers in the first quarter.
Time call here. The Nuggets decide to talk it over.
That was a good time to call the timeout to try to settle everybody down and get back into their offensive rhythm. They've been coughing up the rock an awful lot.
So Utah going with an almost entirely new group. Paul Millsap's checked in for Carter. Reddick comes in for Paul Pierce. Raymond Felton, he's checked in for J.R. Smith. And Barea subbed in for Kyrie Irving. The dive for the ball. Stripped away. Last break, here come the Jazz. Barea with the ball. Lets it go from deep. The rebound by Paul George. George has got his sixth rebound on the night.
You know, they've been outstanding on the boards, and it's a big reason why they've got a lead. Doing the dirty work down low.
Yeah, and Clark, you know, rebounding's a team effort. Everybody's boxing out. Everyone is accountable for doing a nice job collectively.
That was a nice, strong one-hand jam there.
Yeah, brought it back and ripped it down.
Yeah, that's how you do it. That's nice.
Reddick for three. Excellent D there from George. The Nuggets leading by 11.
Oh! Right there. Call it hang time and bang time.
Unbelievable.
You gotta just shake your head on that one.
The three is launched. Good.
And that's his first three-pointer, so maybe that one will get him started.
Here's Paul. Now the dish to Garnett. Dumps it down.
And defensively, you've got to try to keep the ball on the perimeter.
Yeah, he's not going to miss those, not often anyway. The defense has to muscle up and deny him that position to have a chance.
For three, Felton, and the Jazz, another three.
Well, he can shoot the three, we know that, but I'm not sure the D does. I mean, they weren't anywhere near him on that possession.
Outside, George.
Wow. Look at that athletic play. Incredible.
That's taking it strong right there.
Yeah, finishing in style.
You can feel a sense of anticipation when he heads for the hoop because that's what he can do.
Beals checked in for Kyle Korver. Here's Barea. And a miss there on the triple. The Nuggets leading by 12. And now it's Green running. He can go all the way.
Great finish there, Kevin. Took it strong to the cup.
Yeah, aggressive two-handed jam.
And that's the kind you like, especially in traffic. You got to make sure.
Here's Barea. Another miss by Barea. Denver's gone 6 of 10 from three-point range, up over 50% for the ballgame. Garnett, and that one's good. Garnett's got 6 here in this quarter.
They are in attack mode right now. That's 10 straight points, guys, all coming inside the paint.
And Steve, if I'm them, I'd keep going right to the heart of that defense like they have been until they do something about it. If they don't offer resistance, take everything you can get in there.
The open shot, George. Good, and Paul gets the assist. 20 points here for George.
Starting to build ahead of steam here. He had a good first quarter, but he's been even better here in the second.
And here's Felton from the arc. Green with the rebound. Denver's gone 3 of 4 with the long-range bombs here in the second quarter. Here's Redick, defended by George. Shoots the three, and that's good. J.J. Redick for three. Redick's got his third basket of the night. Here's Beal, and a great assist by Paul as that one goes in. And the Nuggets lead by 14. Outside, Felton. From outside the arc, Denver grabs the miss. And led by...
We're tearing that roof down with that one.
Yeah, and really a dunk contest dunk that time. Wow.
Yeah, unreal. What a dunk.
There's the triple. Gets it to go. Felton's got 20.
This guy is on pace to have one of the all-time performances if the defense continues to allow him to knock those down.
Paul kicks to George. Fires for three. A rebound by the Jams. Millsap's got 3 rebounds so far in the game. Here is Barea, defended by George.
Right now, he's in a bit of a funk. I'd look for them to look at other options on offense.
Here's the three. Good, and Paul gets the assist. That's 23 points here for George.
He has taken over this game, guys. I don't know what else you can say about it.
And here's Felton from the arc. That's good.
How do you top 3 made three-pointers in the first quarter? Easy. Convert more of them in the second. Absolutely amazing.
You know, we focus so much on Chris Paul's offensive abilities, but defensively, he's one of the best point guards in the NBA. Perennially at the top of the list in terms of most steals per game. Very strong for a guy who's maybe not as physically imposing as some of the other guards in the league.
Yeah, he is that. He is deceptively strong and has great anticipation, and if he does pilfer it from you, he knows exactly what to do, whether leading the break for a layup for somebody else or getting to the rim for his own basket. I mean, he can dish or switch. Pick your poison with him.
The Nuggets have been exceptional shooting free throws tonight, going 9 for 9. LaMarcus Aldridge has checked in for Brook Lopez. Carter outside. The three. That's good. Carter's got 9 points in the quarter.
Seems to be getting better as this game goes on.
Knocked away. And stolen by Williams. Goes up. And it's Smith missing.
You see the defenders get out of his way a lot of times when he's on his way to the bucket, but not that time.
Horford the pass to Harden. Horford with it, and it's Carter picking him up. Here's Walker. It's good from about 19 feet. Parker's got seven.
He didn't get off to much of a start early on, but he seems to have shaken off the rust here in the quarter.
Carter for three. That's good.
Tell you what, he's draining the three ball at will, guys.
Yeah, he is, and they've got to find a way to get out there on it.
Outside Anthony with the lead pass and stolen by Nash. Good if it goes. Good!
And he barely beats the clock with that three.
Steve, that's it.
And so that's the end of the first half. Nuggets lead by 10. And we'll be back right after. And we're back to the action here in this round one matchup.
It's been a very solid outing for George. He has 23 points, and his huge assist tally makes it all the more impressive.
Well, and he's got this team in such a good groove right now. The way he's moving the ball and passing, getting everybody involved, they're in a great flow.
The Nuggets leading by seven. Outside Anthony. Took the contact and tried to throw it down over the top, but instead he'll shoot free throws.
Nice job there, attacking the rim and drawing the contact.
Yeah, I like that play there. The defense had no choice but to foul in order to save the dunk.
Well, just as we expected, they've made the most of their chances at the free throw line. That's definitely been a factor so far.
Smith for three, and the Jazz another three. Denver's gotten off 12 shots from beyond the arc tonight, hitting seven of them. Paul dishes to Horford, and he bangs it home with one hand.
He's short for the center position, but he makes up for it with tremendous leaping ability.
A three ball, and another three from Smith. Smith's got 28 points for the game.
What a half they're having from beyond the arc. It's getting ridiculous.
And there's no reason they shouldn't keep attacking from out there. I mean, they've got to be going on in a big way now.
You know, when he plays well, generally the team does too, and it's exactly what we're seeing here today.
Three-pointer blocked.
Even with that miss, they're shooting 75% coming out of the break. That's a strong start to the half.
Now, it would have been fun to see him pull it off, but you know, you really need the points here. Just put it in the basket.
Takes the three. Carter kicks to Smith. Back to Carter. From downtown. No good. Now Denver takes it the other way. They led by as many as 18 points. He feeds it to Melo. Launches a three. That's good. And it's a 10-point Nugget lead.
He's been so solid. You've got to keep him out there on the floor. Really doing a nice job for the offense.
Carter with it, and it's Horford picking him up. Wasted no time on that one. And that's 23 points for Vince Carter.
He's been producing all night. It's up to the rest of his team to start kicking in a little bit.
That's good. 25 points here for George.
A nice start to the second half. Just one miss in their first five attempts.
Pierce against George, and the basket by Pierce.
You know, that wasn't the highest quality look, but for him, it doesn't matter. He doesn't need a great look to knock down the three.
Harden the pass to Horford. From deep, George. Rebound by Smith. Smith's got three rebounds so far in the game. Outside, Pierce. And now we're 3 minutes into the third quarter of play. That is good. Pierce has got 19 points. The Nuggets leading by five into Al Horford. Powered down with both hands.
You know, the defense that time was just content to stay out of the way. I mean, no resistance at all. They let him do exactly what he wanted to right there.
Steve, no one looked too anxious to take him on.
No, you know, guys, I think that speaks to his strength and his agility. I mean, he's not a guy you want to stand in the way of as a defender.
So Utah ends up going with the new group. Let's go to the 2K leaderboard. These teams were the best in the charity stripe in the regular season. The Jazz second.
Boy, I tell you what, Kevin, when you have numbers like this from the line, your coach is not only satisfied, but he's confident. Sure, there are some guys whose numbers help offset the weaker shooters, but overall, this has been a solid team from the line.
And now in transition, here's Williams. Here we go. Fires from deep, and it's good. Williams has got six. The Nuggets have gotten 5 of 8 shots to fall for them in the third quarter. A nice 62% from the field.
Sure.
Here's Harden. Finds the bottom of the bucket from 13 feet out. And the Nuggets lead by 6.
My goodness, he's knocking down everything he looks at.
For 3, Felton. And again, it's the Jazz from deep. Here's Paul. Launches it. It's hauled in by Felton. Jazz trailed by 3. Felton off the pick from Millsap. For the tie, Denver grabs the miss. Paul's got 6 rebounds.
Oh, I can't imagine that we'll see one better than that tonight.
I'm with you on that, aren't you, Steve?
Oh, yeah, I'd be shocked if we saw something more entertaining than that one.
And that last replay, courtesy of Sprite. Redick for 3, gets it to go. Redick's got 12 in the game.
I tell you what, he'll be quite contented to sit out there beyond the arc and knock down shot after shot if they're going to play defense like that. Tighten it up out there. Boy, they just cannot figure out a way to stop this guy in this quarter, Kevin.
Here's Lopez. He lays it in. Lopez has got his first basket of the night.
Good job creating an easy bucket there.
Nuggets have gone 8 of 12 from the field since the beginning of the third. Horford's shot is good.
He's a big reason why they have the lead right now. He's made all of his field goal attempts thus far and remains hot from the floor.
Right side, Millsap. Taken away by Anthony. Here's Harden. That one falls, coming off Anthony's feet. Anthony's got 3 assists tonight.
They're just giving up way too many transition hoops.
You know, it's okay to give up a few if you're getting them back on the other end, but that hasn't been the case here.
The Nuggets leading by 4. Harden outside. And a great assist by Paul as that one goes in. And that's 20 points for James Harden. Williams kicks to Redick. Front pass the arc. Offensive rebound. Millsap. And a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot 2 right here. The Jazz have had 2 chances at the line already, making them both. So it's both teams making substitutions here. Both free throws good for Millsap. A tight game here in Denver. Now, here's Lillard, averaging 23 points per contest. Feeds to Garnett. Back to Harden. Good ball movement here by the Nuggets. Lillard, defended by Nash. Pass to Middleton. Down to 5 on the shot clock. And that one's good.
I'll tell you what, right now that mid-range jumper serving them well.
Yes, it is, guys. That's 6 of their last 10 points coming from that mid-range area.
For 3, Smith. The rebound by Middleton.
Boy, just by his body language, Kevin, you can tell he thought that triple was going to fall.
Yeah, a little frustrated now, shaking his head after that miss.
Well, they've done a lot of their damage from mid-range here, guys. I mean, knocking down those shots with regularity.
Yeah, how about 8 of their last 10 points, guys, coming off that mid-range area jump shot. So, shows you don't have to be at the rim to score.
He's going to take that shot every time if he has that much room to get it off.
Oh, look out!
He's definitely showing some real sweet dunking skills here.
Are you kidding me? Oh, my gosh. What a play. Yeah, that was spectacular.
And here's Nash outside. Snatched up. Garnett with the block. Here is Lillard. Still looking to get on the scoreboard. And Anthony gets it to go on the assist by Lillard. And it's a 9-point Nugget lead.
Great display of that mid-range touch right now.
Yeah, there's nothing wrong with taking a step in and knocking down a few. I know you were a great marksman from the 3-point line, but sometimes people only see the game in threes and layups. But that mid-range game is alive and well here tonight.
Here's Middleton. LaMarcus Aldridge grabs the miss.
And no defender was around him to influence that shot. It didn't hurt them there, but, you know, they can't make that mistake twice.
for three. And again, Vince Carter for three. Now it's just a three-point nugget lead.
This is unbelievable. What a shooting exhibition we're seeing out there today.
Here's Harden.
Now that is just simply pure power, fellas. A nasty throwdown right there.
I'm telling you, Steve, this building is an awe.
Is he blessed with amazing athleticism or what? That's just incredible.
Gets it to go. 32 points for Vince Carter.
When you're hot, you're hot. This is unbelievable.
Back to Harden. Pass to Middleton. There's the three. Another three for Denver. Jazz trailed by five. Nash with it. Lillard picks him up. It's Nash with the drive. Three-pointer. And they will call over the back on the play.
He may want to start spreading the ball around a little bit. His shot is off right now. A little over-eager right there. Left his feet too early.
And if you're already boxed out, you've got to try to work to get around. Otherwise, it's a surefire foul.
Looking at who's out there now for the Jazz. Paul Pierce has checked in for Millsap, and Kyrie Irving subbed in for Steve Nash. Carter with the three, and it's Denver with the rebound. Three on three. Horford dishes to Garnett. Harden back to Garnett. Swings it on the run.
Now, the offensive efficiency has been really important. I think that's been the difference.
Well, you know, I think it's pretty simplistic, but it does oftentimes come down to this, making shots. And that's what they've done.
Carter for three. Walker with the rebound. The Nuggets leading by nine. Hands out of bounds. The Nuggets able to retain possession here. And the Nuggets with some changes. Paul George, he's checked in for Korver. And it's Paul in for Kemba Walker. And here are the Nuggets now. And it's going to be out of bounds. The Jazz will take it. Jazz trail by nine. Outside, Pierce. They need this. Hits the bucket. Pierce has got eight here in the quarter. Balanced scoring, Clark and Steve, for them. They're moving it well.
Yeah, you love to see teams share the sugar. Everybody getting a touch, everybody enjoying an opportunity to score. That makes it a lot of fun for everybody on the court.
You know, it sounds better when you say it than watching it. Okay? I like better when you say it. Sharing the sugar. All right, Steve?
Yeah, pass the cream, too. I mean, while you're at it. I mean, this has been something to watch. I mean, just everybody getting involved.
Back to Horford. Goes for the alley-oop.
There's one thing about the alley-oop. You can't fire the pass in there. You got to have some air under that pass. It needs a little hang time.
That's exactly right. A lot of finesse. Just like that one was. Perfectly thrown.
And that's what makes the play so much fun to watch. There's finesse on the front end, but then power on the end.
Pierce for three. Gets it to go. Pierce has got 25 points.
You know, he's yet to miss in the quarter. Flawless efficiency from the field. I like it.
Poked away. Now the feed to Harden. He passes to George. And there's the 3-second violation.
Oh, no, you hate to see that. Those are just the kind of errors that can cost you in a game like this.
Paul Millsap's checked in for Vince Carter. There's the pass to Pierce. Over George. The shot by Pierce will not go.
You know, they've really had the upper hand in rebounding all game long. If the game stays this close, rebounding can play a big part in the end.
Yeah, I agree. I mean, a big advantage for them here, and they certainly needed it.
Ball against Irving. The three is launched. The rebound by Paul George. George has got his seventh rebound here tonight. About 7 seconds separating the shot and game clocks.
You let him get to the rim, and that's exactly what's going to happen. You deserve that.
And he's more than capable. You're right, Clark, of providing some great highlight reel material.
Yes, sir. And for a point guard to finish like that, I mean, that is just special. He has not lost his focus today. Even when things haven't gone his team's way, he's still bringing it.
Paul passes to Carmelo. Knocks it loose. Outside, Pierce. And no good trying to get that one. And that does it for the third quarter. Both teams clicking up. As the fourth quarter gets going, let's swing it over to Doris Burke to find out who's had the Sprite uncontainable game. Doris?
Hey, Kevin. Our uncontainable game in this one, the stretch by the Nuggets. Things really opened up for them in the second period, and they were able to strike while the iron was hot. Very strong effort from the whole team this game.
Doris, thank you. And what a concerted effort they put together tonight.
And, you know, that was really the uncontainable aspect in this game, Kevin. They got on the same page as a team and pretty much did what they wanted for the entire stretch.
Well, clearly it's a different game without that scoring run. That was a game-changing run, no doubt.
Let's the free fly. Gets it to go. Pierce has got 28 points for the game.
Just an unbelievable display of offense here today.
Well, it seems like every shot that goes up finds its way to the hoop. I mean, every player is sharp and on target.
Paul for three, and the shot is good. Here's Irving. Smith outside, and again it's the Jazz from deep. And we've played through about a minute here in the fourth.
The Nuggets leading by four.
And there's the ball on Kyrie Irving. That's his third foul of the game. James Harden, he's checked in for Beal. And Utah with a change here, too. Carter's checked in. Now Harden, Garnett outside. Paul, covered by Irving. And Paul gets it to go in.
Chris Paul has got that hot hand going.
Jazz trailed by six. Irving kicks to Smith. Fires from deep. And the Jazz, another three. Final quarter of play, about a minute and a half off the clock into it. Harden against Smith. Beyond the arc. And there's Paul George on the assist by Harden. Harden's got assist number 11 for him here tonight. Smith for three. Excellent D there from George.
Even against solid defense, he's still going to try to continue to make that shot.
Yeah, no doubt. I mean, I wouldn't bet against him in that situation next time.
Anytime they've needed a hoop, he's taken over one shot after another. Boy, is he playing well.
Pierce for three. Gets it to go. Pierce has got six in the quarter. The Nuggets leading by five. Paul kicks to George. Good ball movement here by the Nuggets. Second chance shot. Puts up a three. That one goes. Count. George has got 12 points here in the second half.
Getting the feel out there from long range, guys. That's his second three of the half.
Pierce for three. That's good.
He's had a big half from beyond the arc. When he's this hot, the green light doesn't get much greener.
And there's the call on Kyrie Irving. That will get him his fourth foul of the game.
He's going to have to be very careful, guys, because that's his fourth foul now, so we'll see how he responds.
And the Nuggets making a change here. Anthony's checked in. Steve Nash, he's checked in for the Jazz. And there's a whistle that's going to go on James Harden. That's his first foul. Jazz trailed by five. Nash dishes to Pierce. Here's the three. Denver grabs the miss. Horford's got nine rebounds in the game. Getting it done.
My goodness, he sure can get off the ground.
One of the best in the business for sure, you're right.
Such an imposing finisher around the rim. Intimidating to the defense, really.
Nash's shot is off.
Boy, even though he missed, you can't give up that kind of a look very often.
Yeah, they're lucky that they didn't get burned on that one.
Over 3.5 minutes through the final quarter now. Smith outside.
And he's good on the three ball. Smith's got 40 points.
Well, with his team struggling, he is taking it upon himself to get them back into this game. These are incredible rebounding numbers. I'm not sure if we've ever seen anything like this, Clark.
That's for sure, Steve. I mean, a superhuman performance on the backboards. Well done.
Utah calls timeout.
For Utah. Doris Burke has some information for us. Doris?
I was able to listen in on what Tyrone Corbin was going over with his team. He is not happy with their perimeter defense, saying, guys, way too many open shots for them beyond the three-point line. We've got to press up closer and try to crowd them off the arc. Guys, we'll see if they got the message.
For three, Felton can't get it to go. And the Nuggets going the other way. They led by as many as 18 points. Paul kicks to Horford. The big shot at the end of the break.
No way to mess that one up, Kevin. I mean, he powered it down with both hands.
Not this guy. He is a superb finisher.
Man, he is an absolute force when he gets near the hoop.
Williams can't get it to go. The Nuggets leading by 10. Into Al Horford. And stolen by Williams. Here's Reddick, guarded by Harden. And that's good. J.J. Redick for three.
Another turnover and another hoop the other way.
You know, a lot of the points they've given up, guys, have been the result of turnovers. And when you turn it over, there's no way to set your defense. Better offense will lead to better defense because you do have a chance to get set. They've got to bring the double team on him.
Yeah, I would have expected to see that already, Clark.
Are you kidding me? They're like different guys this half. They haven't missed a single free throw.
Stepping up and knocking him down, Clark.
Launches it, and the shot is good. Reddick's got 21.
Tell you what, until he cools off, we got to keep going to him.
Denver's gone beyond the arc 7 times here in the fourth and been successful 3 times. And a dunk by Horford.
I don't think it's possible to make a better pass than that, guys.
And he finished so well, Clark, too. Not too shabby on that jam.
Not bad at all.
And it takes perfect timing to pull off that alley-oop, but these two guys seem to have that synergy between each other.
Reddick with the bucket.
Big mistake not having more defensive pressure on him out there.
Denver calls timeout. Marcus Aldridge has checked in for Utah. The Nuggets leading by 6. He kicks to Paul. He's against Williams. Here's Anthony. Outside for George. Pass to Carmelo. From past the arc, they get it back. And a dunk by Horford.
Well, you love his motor and the effort level that's there on the offensive boards. That's always there. And those are the kind of things that create extra possessions for a team. And ultimately, you know, NBA games are generally close, so 2-3 extra possessions in a game can turn out to be the difference between winning and losing.
And you know what? He's a guy who will put some wood on you now. He'll throw his weight around. Bodying him up play after play can really wear you down.
Here's Paul. That's tipped. Taken away by Felton. Shoots it up. Good work defensively by Paul. And here is Anthony. Harden kicks to George. Pushes it down.
Well, after he threw that one down, he felt free to hang around for a little while.
A little extra emphasis at the end.
Now, you got to be careful, too, on that. It's used to be an automatic technical foul. They'll still call it at times, but they're a little more selective with the call.
Outside Williams. Reddick. Launches a three. Good on the shot. Reddick's got 30.
Much in the clutch. He's 5 for 5 from the field here in the fourth.
Well, they keep giving him the ball, and it's working, so I wouldn't change a thing.
The three from Harden. That drops. And the Nuggets lead by 7.
I think they're trying to go for the kill here. I mean, they're starting to take a lot more three-point shots than they had been before, looking to run away.
Yeah, that's fine as long as you're making them, but make sure you don't start launching bad shots. That's a problem.
Denver's gone over and over to the three-point shot in the fourth quarter. 4 of 9. Outside for George. Back to Harden. And the shot is good. Harden's got 5 points now in the quarter.
And they keep going right back to the paint. And who can blame them? I mean, they're getting it done in there.
Yeah, 3 of their last 5 buckets, guys, have come from inside the lane area. So I expect them to continue to go inside right at the defense.
Reddick with the three. And again, it's the Jazz from deep.
He may single-handedly bring his team back, guys. What a fantastic quarter he's having.
Dishes it to Harden. Lots of room. Again, the Nuggets score.
Boy, both teams showing a lot of hustle, Clark.
Steve, especially since halftime. I mean, they're flying around out there, giving up a lot of energy and putting together a pretty good show.
The shot by Reddick, no good.
You know, even though he missed that one, great shooters have a way of feeling when they've got enough room to pull the trigger.
Yeah, and not enough defensive coverage there to prevent him from firing that time. But I think if he's open, he's got to let that thing fly.
How's that for an encore after the offensive board?
That's the only way he knows how to do it. Monster stuff.
Oh, he makes life miserable down around the paint for anybody who's trying to box him out.
And if they know what's good for him, that's the way they'll defend against him every time he takes the ball into three-point territory.
Well, you're right. Anything less than airtight defense on him will usually result in 3 points. Boy, the defense just can't control him. They can't find a way to stop him.
Well, maybe a triple team, huh? Even that might not be enough, but it's worth a try.
And the Jazz call time here.
Coach can't be pleased with their inconsistency on the defensive glass. They've been caught taking pictures out there. They're watching, as opposed to getting in there and securing the orange.
For the Jazz. Jazz trail by 9. Smith outside. 3-pointer. Paul George grabs the miss. George has got double-digit rebounds now in the game. And Paul slams it in.
I love the flow that they've been playing with offensively tonight. This is an impressive performance.
Well, and that lead they have just continues to grow and grow.
Nash with the bucket.
He's really picked up where he left off in the first.
The Nuggets leading by 8. And the first one at the line is good. And so he makes both from the line. Here's Smith. Nash outside. Here's the triple. And the Jazz, another 3. Denver's gone over and over to the 3-point shot in the fourth quarter. 4 of 9. Harden outside. And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Steve Nash. That'll be foul number 5 on him. And due to the bonus, we'll be headed to the free throw. Harden hits them both. And the Jazz with possession. They trail by 9 points. There's Nash with the 3. Count that one. Nash has got 9 points in the quarter.
He might not get a better look than that all game. You have to get closer to him. He's not going to bite you. Get up in him.
And it's Anthony with the jam.
Ammonia strong finish right there, partner. You hear me? That was ammonia strong.
Yeah, ripped it down with 2 hands.
That's about as high percentage as you can get.
Nash outside. And the Jazz, another 3. The Nuggets leading by 5. The 3 from Harden. And again, Denver with the triple.
He's got the touch they needed here as this one goes down to the wire.
Yeah, absolutely. He's 4 for 4. He knows he needs every basket. I would look for them to continue to get the ball in his hands.
Nash with the bucket.
There's been no pressure from his standpoint in the fourth quarter. I mean, he's made 5 of the 6 shots.
Horford kicks to George.
What a play. No regular dunk there. A superb alley-oop.
And it was a great pass, too, to set him up.
No, those two have such a great feel for each other. They're just fun to watch play together.
Nash outside. Paul grabs the board. And so here's Denver. They led by as many as 18 points. Anthony, the pass to Paul, tries to save it.
That's going to be tough here, Clark.
You know, I agree with you, Steve. I mean, they need some big plays to steal this one.
Jacks up a three, buries it, and now they trail by just four. They can more or less wrap it up right here.
Yeah, as long as they concentrate, get a good look at the basket, make this a smart possession, they should be in good shape.
Oh, trying for it. And it's out of bounds to the Nuggets as Denver retains possession. Back to George. Good ball movement here by the Nuggets. Paul dishes to Horford. And a great assist by Paul as that one goes in. And that's now 37 points for Horford. The Jazz making a switch here. Aldridge has checked in. The Jazz shooting one of the high points for them in this game at 54%. Paul against Nash. Smith back to Nash. Nash drawing the double team. Out of bounds. Denver takes possession.
Well, that's inexcusable to throw a pass that far off the mark.
And here's Harden. So the Nuggets win it. Well, teams play well, but these guys have the edge.
Point out the bounce.